Yo. What's up, everybody? RichKitch20 here, back with Evanescence album. Evanescence. Today we have Erase This, which is sixth track on here. The only reason I know that is because I noticed how far we were getting, and I was like, are we halfway through? And then I noticed it's 6 out of 12, so like, we are exactly halfway through after this song, so halfway through the album. I feel like I haven't listened to a lot of their songs, but I also feel like I've listened to a lot of their songs on this album, so I guess it kind of makes sense for it to be halfway. I've heard the first like 3 or 4 seconds because I was listening through the album again, which, by the way, I forgot how good of songs on this album. Like, everyone is just so catchy. I was just like, oh yeah, man, this album is really good, because I don't even really remember two. Then listening to the other ones, I was like, oh yeah, these are really good, I remember that. And then I heard like a few seconds of this episode, I was like, oh, pause, shit, you know. But yeah, just heard the piano and the drums and stuff kicking it off. I was like, oh damn, it's gonna be a hot start. So I'm excited for that. By the way, as I mentioned in the last video, but if you did not watch the With Him Temptation video, Illidan's finally back. Had to take him down and go get him patched up in the shop because he was peeling. I don't know how that managed to happen, but hey, you know, accidents happen. And then I've had it probably ready to go back up for like a good month or two, if not longer. And I just didn't want to because I knew it was going to be a long endeavor that was going to take at least an hour. And it did. It took about an hour and a half, 2 hours to get everything like put. Because, you know, I wanted to bring it down a little. But when you bring one of them down, you have to bring five of them down and get them all rebalanced at the right height and then put in the actual hooks in it. So I didn't want to put him up for a while, but he's up now, and whatever happens, he's staying like that. And even if all of a sudden it just is tilted the other way when I wake up in the morning, I don't care, it's staying. Because I'm not doing that again, or I'm going to hire someone to do it. So, but as neither here nor there, we are here to listen to some awesome Evanescence music. How do I know it's going to be awesome? I just got what's called a hunch. Because, you know, it's a reaction, you haven't seen it before, so that always pops through my mind, like, it's going to be awesome, and then it's like, well, how do you know it's going to be awesome? It's like, well, you know what, I don't know, but let's just say I'm assuming. Alright, Erase This, which could be about very dark, or potentially not, or healing, or something, who knows. I'm ready to find out, though, so let's let it roll.
Every day I'm waking up with someone else.
There were some funky ass beats in that song. Like the rhythm switch ups from the difference between the intros and the outros, the verses and the chorus, each had their own unique rhythm to it, which were all very cool. Right out the gate, the passion and energy in Amy's vocals, top notch stuff right there. The guitar had some shredding ass moments in the song, man. There was some sick guitar moments in there, and I'm looking forward to getting to. The drums also were taking this song for a walk. They were having a good time, and they were driving certain rhythms that were really cool that I want to go check out. Of course, Amy's harmonies, standard, like, just, they work so well every time. Like, that girl knows how to write the fuck out of harmonies, man. Like, I don't know if she became a harmoniologist. Real word, look it up. I don't know if that was like that. That was like a endorsement she added on top of her degrees, her music degree. I know she went to. Oh God, I haven't watched that interview in so long. I know she went to college for music. Did she graduate? I want to say. I can't remember if she either did. Obviously, she either did or didn't. Like, obviously, there's two choices. But I feel like. I can't remember if she stopped halfway through and formed Evanescence instead. Or if she graduated or not. Either way, let's just assume she graduated. I don't know if this is an endorsement on top of her education of harmoniologist. But, like, it would make sense. Like, she really focused in on harmonies when she was studying music. Because, damn, she know how to write the fuck out of harmonies, man. She's really good at those. Like, they're always addicting with her beautiful, haunting tones that she can just seamlessly slide into her vocals. When she uses those to harmonize with herself, get after it. It's over, man. She's so good. Yeah, but only like thing for me is the chorus felt like a little like kind of tried and true copy and paste a little bit, like vocally. Everything else was pretty fresh and unique, but it felt a little like I've heard that from this album before. Like, bony a little bit. Like, not enough to be like, okay. You know, I was like, no, it's still fine. It's just like, if I was getting the sense, like, I feel like I've heard this before on this album. So, like, a teensy bit of repetitiveness there in the chorus. But that's besides that. It's like, wonderful song right there. Wonderful song. Let's not waste any time, shall we? Let's get back into the beginning here. What do I got? So all before the chorus, all before 45 seconds in. So right off the rhythm that the drums and the piano come in with, wonderful, love it. And then the guitar comes in, starts doing that rhythm and but putting some fucking rocking and almost like metal like stank on that guitar line. Fucking wonderful. It was really, really cool. And then there's some very interesting background vocals that came in there. That I want to hear those again. The energy, just both the vocal line and just all the instruments just came with the height of the energy and just pushed it like right from the word play. Like just good energy just in everything. Not only the instruments but the vocal lines. And there's that part there. Can't remember if it's we can't wash these sins away or sinking feeling every day. I feel like it's one of those two lines, but I can't remember. Could be the end of the verse. I don't fully remember. Somewhere in there, she had that fucking epic high note that she did later as well. And I don't know if I marked it down when it happened later. I think I did, but I can't remember. But yeah, all that before the chorus. So I want to check all that shit. So let's get that. I like the feel of that rhythm. It feels like it starts out like a slightly slower three note. I want to say phrase or maybe. It's like the whole motif of it is switching between two sections. One slower three note, and then maybe one like five note faster five note phrase. Like dun dun dun. Dun 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 dun, kind of like going back and forth between that dun 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 dun, you know, like exaggerating to get the effect, but kind of like a slightly slower and then a little bit faster and then slightly slower, you know. It's just going back and forth between that dun 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 dun. You know, I love that rhythm. That is a nice rhythm right there. It just sets the energy tone right out the gate. Love that. That guitar is sick though. I just heard that background vocals I was talking about creeping into my ears there. So we rewind here a little bit so we can just feel that fucking that guitar though. And then let's listen for those background vocals creeping in. No. There's three notes there, just so quiet, but if you're listening you can hear them just creeping at the bottom of your ears. And then Amy comes in with her vocals, which again also just immediately comes out with that energy and just like that, just that passion just immediately just kicking right on. That's so cool. I like that switch there. It's too late to change your mind, even though this fragile world. Right when it gets to around, I think it's either right when it gets to around fragile world or right after. I think it's even though this fragile world, and then that section, everything before that, and is tearing apart at the seams. I think that line there. It sounds like the drums switch to more kind of treble cymbals and stuff like that. It's rolling on the hi-hat. You know, it's playing around with this fast rhythm on that hi-hat, but I think it switches to some more airy, kind of like very trebly cymbal hits in there, which kind of gives that part this like kind of more open, like almost slower, like it's increasing the subdivision or slowing down the subdivision a little bit to like a little bit slower, and then it goes back to just the hi-hat. Listen for that. There's a change there. I don't think it necessarily slows it down, but you're getting, maybe it's just opening the hi-hat a little bit more. I feel like there's also a cymbal hit in there as well. But yeah, listen to the cymbals from the drums. Right when this fragile world is, it just breaks into that higher cymbal sound. Yeah, it's both. He hits, I would assume, the crash cymbal there, and then opens the hi-hat a little bit more, so it's more tss, and then after the, when after it goes back into the we can't wash away these sins away, he closes back the hi-hat back to where it was after he hits the cymbal again, and it kind of brings everything back to where it was. It's an interesting little change up there for that section, and the way she's singing it slightly differently, a little bit more elongated. It's a nice rhythmic shake up there, nice sound shake up to kind of match what the vocals are doing differently at that part. Cool, I'm gonna go back a little bit further so you can really get that transition to and from that change up there. Can't watch these sins It is at the end. Someone else's life. That. I can't hit that note. Especially not today. My voice is already pretty affected. But yeah. Nice high jump she did up there. Oh, I want to get the build up into that. That's gorgeous. On the sizz of Elsa's, someone else sizz. That is really cool. Love it. All right, let's move along here. So I want to check out the chorus. I mean, the chorus is good. It ain't bad. But what I really want to check out is the drum rhythm. Sorry. Is the drum rhythm in that chorus. It sounds like I think it's in a tripled meter. I'm getting like 3/4 from this whole song, like right when I was talking about things in the beginning. Big here between that dun 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 dun. Really gave me a triple kind of feel in general, but I wasn't gonna make the assumption that was in 3/4. But I don't know. I'm getting a little bit of a 3/4 feel from the song, but now it's in 4. Yeah, it's in 4, but it has this triple feel to it. So maybe it's a little bit more complicated measure, but I don't know. But yeah, it switches between this duple feel to this triple feel to a duple feel for one beat, or at least for one cycle of 1/2, and then back into the triple feel, which will make more sense when we listen to it here again. But listen for that. Listen for that. See if you can. Before I repeat it back, let's see if you can catch it yourself. Listen for that. But this is something that I was catching. You might have seen my mouth, like kind of mouthing it. This is something I caught like as the song was going, which is usually rare. Usually I don't catch it till afterwards because I like feel that there's something interesting about it, but like I don't really pick it up till I listen to it again. It's like caught it at first listen. I was impressed with myself, and I jammed myself in what would be ear or headphone. So let's see if you can pick up that triple duple thing there. That's pretty easy, but maybe you didn't notice it. Who knows? It's hard to keep my head from moving at that time. Try not to give it away for you. Is it 3 threes or 2 threes? Let me hear it again. Yeah, it's a continuous cycle of 2 threes, 1 2. 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 1 2 3. So it's giving it that ta 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 ta. It just has this very stroby ta 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 feel to it. It's 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 1 2 3, 1 2 1 2 3, 1 2 1 2 3. It gives it this nice like kind of hiccup in the feel of the rhythm, which makes it feel like, oh, very interesting phrase or interesting rhythm to it. It's like, oh, it's a weird shakeup. It's just simply switching between two sets of three and one set of two, back and back and back. That's really cool. Listen to that. It does something different there. Hold on, give me a second. I think I was having feelings like, is it gonna repeat the two? Hold on. That's the same thing. It just has a little drum feel on top of it, so it can distract me. But yeah, I like that. I really like that rhythm. It has this nice driving strobe, like feel to it. That's really cool. That's really, really cool. I like that. And of course, I love Amy's held notes here. Very, very classic Amy Lee. Very beautifully done. But I will actually go back we'll go into that again because I want to listen to those harmonies. I noticed the harmonies in the second chorus, and I wasn't really paying attention to the first chorus because they're really paying attention to the rhythm from the drums. But let me let's call it those harmonies now. I love her low hauntingness. It's like, so gorgeous. Yeah, very beautiful low harmonies. And I think I even heard maybe another voice up in the top end. I'm already hearing two voices, but I could easily see some doubling potentially on her voice. She might have sung it twice and put it on there just for that extra heightened, because it really sounds like her high line is like really full and powerful, and that could just be production in general. But I want to say that they layered that line on top of itself to give it the extra oomph of just that strength on top of there. Not that Amy can't do that strength by herself, but it does sound like there's a little bit of doubling going on there. But I could be completely wrong with that. That's a guess. But it sounds like there's another harmony line up there because of how full it sounds up there. And there might just be them not picking up, or it could be that her line is doubled. But I do not know. Either way, love the fucking harmonies, man. She has amazing fucking harmonies. All right. I wrote something about the harmonies at 125. I don't know what's going on 125, but we're going to jump ahead here and listen to them. It could be the same harmonies that we heard before. Did I mention it? I don't know if I did. So let's listen to that. I'm going to save this wasted life, and nothing can stand in my way. Yeah. Yeah, those four harmonies flip on each other. I think it starts out with the main voice and the harmony. Harmony on the lower end. I think at one point they flip. Hold on, let me hear it out again. Either that or they meet each other in the same line. But yeah, once, like, it's really hard to hear. You just kind of hear this humming, beautiful low tone in that line. But if you pay attention, it's actually her harmonizing with herself. And then I think it either jumps up to the same higher note, or I think it flips at one point. That is, wrong way. That is beautiful. Nice harmony on that little jump up. That same high jump there. I love it. Alright, we're going to jump a little bit further here. Around 155. Said chorus fall off. Don't remember what that means. Plus into the breakdown here. And there's this cool section during the breakdown with the vocals, the piano, and the guitar were doing crazy awesome stuff. But she had this very beautiful long note that she was just playing with, doing these cool embellishments on. Like, Jesus. something about a whole note, I think, is just around the same thing. And the instruments as well. So I want to listen to all that. A lot that came down in and happened here. So I want to listen to all that. That harmony is just as beautiful. It's like you can just hear the nice low fullness it has to itself. It just gives the whole line this like. Humming drone to it. It's gorgeous. So yeah, I remember how this just dissolved Like, the first off, I cannot erase this darkness in me. I don't think she says that anywhere else. That's specifically at the end of... There's something different at the end of every chorus. First one's just because I cannot erase this lie. Second one changes to because I cannot erase this darkness in me. And then the last one still has the I cannot erase this lie, but it starts with the only time it goes to if I could just erase my mind, but I cannot, then goes to but I cannot erase this lie. So each one, it does something different at the end. The end of this second chorus here, it just dissolves. Like, everything breaks up. The word this, she jumps up to this beautiful high note and just holds that while darkness kind of like almost blurs and melts into its own note. Like, something interesting going on at the end of this chorus here. Okay. The water's rising around. So we got the vocal line with sounds like some string cupping and mitt kind of just filling up the sound around here. Let's see where it goes from here. There is no other way down. I only have myself. There's the piano. I feel like the piano was there though. Hold on. The water's rising around us. Not yet. Yeah, no, the piano, it feels like the piano was there the whole time. When I heard that, I was like, was it? I'm like, no, it wasn't. But yeah, the piano kind of comes in there. Some nice hits coming in after the vocal lines there. There is no other way down. It's harmony. It sounds like a three-part harmony. So we got some nice harmony slice, open notes coming on here. Piano still playing away. There's some really good treble cymbal hits. It sounds like it's hitting right on the rim, not the rim, the center of the cymbal in there. There's very nice trebly cymbal hits coming in there. Very thin. Great supporting chords for the guitars. There's so much happening in that space there. And the strings, of course. So drum fills. Beautiful piano notes and chords going on there with that very high violin line kind of taking the lead. Beautiful piano right there. So now sounds like we're back to the chorus for the last time here. At the end of the chorus, really sick guitar outro, which I can't remember if it's the same as the guitar intro, but let's hope we can figure that out this time. Love that little dig-a-da-da coming from the kick pedal there. That's cool. I don't think that's what happened in the beginning. Right? 3-4-3-4-y. No, that's different. It's a cool little fucking rockin' solo there at the end. This meow. As the cymbal hits, just finish that off. man, instrumentally, there's so much going on in that song. So many rhythm changes, so much happening there. Vocally, the harmony game was next motherfucking level. The end of the second chorus was into the breakdown was so fucking cool. The breakdown stuff was so fucking cool. The verses were really great. My God, there's a lot to love about that song, man. There's a lot to love about that motherfucking song. That song was cool. I really liked that. I really liked the different effects and stuff that were happening in that song. But as always, especially for me, the harmonies is where Amy like really wins me over like every single time, man. Her beautiful, haunting low harmonies in these songs just never gets old for me. It's gorgeous, this motherfucker. I love it. Fucking, I love her harmonies, man. Whew. So that's gonna do it for us here on this song. Next we have Lost in Paradise. I think I'm thinking of a different song. Hold on, let me check that real fast. I just want to make sure, because I'm pretty sure the one I'm thinking of. Yeah, no. I'm thinking of something different. Is it Paradise Lost? Temptation, something about Paradise. Is it just called Paradise? Okay. Paradise, parentheses, what about us? Because I was just like, isn't that the one with Tarja? But I was like, no, that's within Temptation. Is there someone else on that? Nah, I got that confused with Temptation and Tarja, which I still need to hear that song, because I imagine that's a really good song, but like, that's some other day. That's different. Anyways, Paradise Lost. Or Lost in Paradise. Lost in Paradise, right. Paradise Lost, I think, is a band. Or at least a song by a band, but I think it's a band. Anyways, we don't need to look that up. So, erase this fantastic Lost in Paradise is next. Thank y'all for joining me. As always, Evanescence, thank you so much for the music, and I will see you all next time.